वेलकम बैक अगेन स्टूडेंट, दिस इज थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ आवर सेकेंड चैप्टर लॉन्ग वॉक टू फ्रीडम. सो लेट्स बिगिन फ्रॉम हियर. आफ्टर द ओरल कॉम्प्रिहेंशन चेक नंबर टू वी विल बिगिन हियर फ्रॉम दिस पैराग्राफ. इन लाइफ एवरी मैन हैज ट्विन ऑब्लिगेशंस. ट्विन मीन टू ऑब्लिगेशंस, टू रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज. वन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू हिज फैमिली, to his parents, to his wife and children, and he has an obligation to his people, his community, his country. One obligation towards the family and the other obligation is towards his country. In a civil and human society, each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclinations and abilities. See here, in a civil and inhuman society, each man is able to fulfill these obligations. Every one of us, almost every one of us, is able to fulfill all these responsibilities according to his own inclinations, natural tendencies and abilities. Means according to one's ability, everyone does fulfill these responsibilities and obligations. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both of those obligations. But as if we talk about the black Africans, and that also before independence, that also before we got freedom, it was very hard to fulfill those obligations. In South Africa, a man of color, a man of color means a dark-skinned person who attempted to live as a human being, was punished and isolated. Means if he considered himself a normal human being, he would have been punished and isolated and was separated from the society in the country like South Africa, which was not free, which was under the rule of Britishers. In South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart, a twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. See, in South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people, tried to fulfill his duty towards his people, towards his country, was inevitably, means unavoidably, ripped from his family. He would barely torn off. He had not torn, actually. He would be separated from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart. Forced to live a life apart means he would be sent to jail. A twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. A gloomy existence of secrecy. Secrecy means secretly he would be put in the jail, secretly he would be put behind the bars in the prison, secretly, and he would be called a rebel if he tries to fulfill his duties toward his country. I did not in the beginning those two place my people above my family, but in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son, a brother, a father, and a husband. I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above my family, means I was just a simple fellow. He is now here in this paragraph is telling how did he become the leader who stood against the apartheid system. See, he was also a normal human being, a very common human being. In the beginning, like a common person, he always put his family before his country. But in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was prevented from. But when I started doing my duty towards my people, towards my country, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son, a brother, a father, and a husband. I found that, I realized that the white people prevented me. They just put me in the prison and I could not fulfill my obligations and my responsibilities as a son, a brother, and a father, and a husband. I was not born with a hunger to be free. I was born free. Means, see here, very important lines again. I was not born with a hunger to be free. Means when I was born, I didn't know that I was a slave. I was born to the slave people. I was born free. Free in every way that I could know. Free to run in the fields near my mother's hut. Free to swim in the clear stream that ran through my village. Free to roast mealies. Mealies means the maize, sweet corn, under the stars, and ride the broad backs of slow-moving bulls. As long as I obeyed my father and abided by the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or God. Means, see here the journey of a person. When he is born, he's born free. And the childhood, free to run in the fields of the mother's heart, free to swim in the clear stream. Clear stream is a small river. Free to roast sweet corn under the stars and ride the broad backs of slow-moving bulls. As long as I obeyed my father and abided by the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or God. Means, as long as I obeyed my father and I followed the traditions, the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or God. Means I was a free being. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion. Means the freedom that I thought I was free, the freedom that I actually celebrated, the freedom that I celebrated, I mean to say here, that I enjoyed as a young boy, I just began to wonder, began to wonder that my boyhood freedom was an illusion. When I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, that I began to hunger for it. Means when I grew into a boy, an adult, from my boyhood, I found that my freedom was an illusion. I was already a slave. I had already become a slave of someone, and my freedom was taken from me. That I began to hunger for it, and then only I understood. Then only I realized that I needed to be free, and a hunger. I conceived a hunger for it inside me. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom from myself, the transitory freedoms of being able to stay out at night, read what I pleased and go where I chose. And later, as a young man in Johannesburg, I yearned for the basic and honorable freedoms of achieving my potential, of earning my keep, of marrying and having a family, the freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful life. See here, the three phases of a human being have been described. What did he mean by freedom when he was a boy? And what did he mean by freedom when he grew into a young man? And then when he went to the college, what did it mean for him? See here, when I discovered at first as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself. When he was a student, he considered freedom his personal thing. He wanted it for himself only. The transitory freedoms for being able to stay out at night means he thought he should be given the permission to stay out at night with his friends and read what he really enjoyed to read and go wherever he wanted to go. Later, a young man in Johannesburg, I yearned for the basic and honorable freedom of achieving my potential. When he was in Johannesburg, he longed for the basic and honorable freedoms, like starting whatever he wanted to do, or whatever he wanted to study, or earning my keep. Of earning my keep means earning my keep means earning my salary, or you can say doing a job and earning the salary from it, of marrying, of getting married with whom I liked, and having a family, the freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful life. And I didn't want it to be obstructed. It to be obstructed means the freedom to be obstructed in a lawful life. I didn't want any laws which could bind me, and which could take away the freedom from me. But then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, but my brothers and sisters were not free. Yes, but slowly then I realized, slowly, very slowly, that it was not only me that was not free. all the people around me, my brothers, my sisters, they all were not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed, reduced, but the freedom of everyone who looked like I did, means all the people around him, his family members, his relatives, his neighbors, they all, he just realized very soon, although very slowly, that they were also not free people. That is when I joined the African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greater hunger for freedom. And when I realized that the people across the world, across my country, were actually not free people, then I joined the African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom. And then I realized that I wanted freedom for all the people of South Africa, for all the people of my family, for all the people of my city. So he joined the National Congress. It was this desire for the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect, and that animated my life. Animated my life means gave a spark to my life, means now it had become the aim of my life. What was the aim? The desire for freedom of my people. I wanted my people free from the rule of white people, to live their lives with dignity, with self-respect and dignity. They could be able to live their lives. That animated my, means that gave my life a goal. That idea of freedom, achieving freedom from the white people, gave me an idea, gave me life to my life. Life to my life means gave a spark to my, gave an aim to my life that transformed a frightened young man. Who's the young man? He himself is calling the young man. That that transformed a frightened, frightened means earlier I was scared of everything. A young man into a bold one means, but now after realizing the aim of my life, I had become bold. That drove a law-abiding attorney to become a criminal. That turned a family-loving husband into a man without a home. That forced a life-loving man to live like a monk. See here. So these are the transformations which happened in his life. Let's see what happens in his life. That transformed a frightened young man into a bold one. Earlier he was a frightened young man, that he became a bold one. That drove a law-abiding attorney to become a criminal. Criminal in the eyes of white people, because he stood against their rule. That turned a family-loving husband into a man without a home. He had to leave his family. He forced a life, that forced a life-loving man to live like a monk. Life-loving man means he loved all the luxuries of his life, but he had to live life like a monk, and he had to spend very precious years of 30 years of his life in the prison. So I'm no longer virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man, but I found that I could even enjoy the poor and limited freedoms I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. I'm not virtuous means I was not better than any other common person in my area, in my country, or self-sacrificing. I was not better than any of the people, any of the persons in my country. I was just a common man, but I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedoms. Poor and limited freedom means I was the husband, I was a loving son, I was an attorney, I was a young man. So these were the limited concepts of freedom. So I could not enjoy these limited concepts of freedom. When I came to know, when I realized that my people were not free, that my country was not a free country, that my people were the slaves of white people. Freedom is indivisible. Freedom is indivisible, means you can't divide it. The chains of any one of my people were the chains on all of them. Means if someone was slave among us, someone was slave from my community, means we all were considered the slaves. You can't say that only he is the slave of white people and we were not. We were also considered the slaves. So it was indivisible. You can't divide that the particular person was doing the job of a housekeeper in the house of a white person. That's why only he is the slave, I am not. No, we were all considered the slaves. So it was indivisible. You can't divide someone was free or someone was a slave. The chains on all of my people were the chains on me. And I felt that if they were all slaves, I was also the slave. If I was slave, they were also the slaves. I knew that the oppressor must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. Means both the oppressor, the person who ill-treats someone, who exploits someone, and the person who is ill-treated by someone, who is, you can say, the victim, they both were not free. See here, a man who takes away another man's freedom is the prisoner of hatred. Means the exploit, the person who exploits others, he is the prisoner of hatred. Means he hates someone, he can't let the hatred go out of his heart. He is locked behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. Means he is prejudiced. He has a particular notion about the color of the skin. Means he cannot come out of those bars. If someone is black, he should be hated. And if I'm white, I should be, you can say, I'm better than the other ones. And narrow-mindedness means he is the slave of, if we as black people, the slaves were the slaves of white people, thus the white people were the slaves of hatred, prejudice and narrow-mindedness. I'm not only truly free if I'm thinking I'm taking away someone else's freedom. Means if the white people think that they were free, no, they were also not free. They were also the slaves, and the slaves of prejudice, narrow-mindedness and the hatred. Just as surely as I'm not free when the freedom is taken from me, means just as they were also sailing in the same boat as we black people were sailing in the boat of oppression. The oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. Means the oppressor, the person who exploits, he is inhuman, and the oppressor, he is treated inhumanly, so they both are robbed of their humanity. Okay, that's all from the chapter. So this can be the theme of the chapter. Means both the person who takes some other's freedom, and he is the slave of hatred, prejudice and narrow-mindedness, and the other is the slave of the white people. He is also robbed of his humanity. That's all in this chapter. Let's very quickly go through the questionnaire. What twin obligations does Mandela mention? The twin obligations, I think, here the obligation of family and the obligation towards the country. Next is, what did being free man mean to Mandela as a boy, as a student? How does he contrast these transitory freedoms and with the basic and the honorable freedoms here? See, as a boy, he enjoyed the little pleasures of life, and as an adult, the freedom appeared very illusionary for him. As a student, he wanted to have freedom. He wanted freedom for himself only, and perceived he wanted to go at night outs. He wanted to read whatever he wanted to read. He wanted to go where he wanted to go. As an adult, he realized that freedoms perceived by him as a boy and as a student were transitory in nature, because what was important was to be able to achieve one's potential and freedom to earn a livelihood and to marry and to have a family. Means as an adult, he wanted to have such freedoms, to get married to someone whom he liked, and to earn his livelihood and to reach to his potentials, exploit to his potentials, explore to his potentials. So these were the basic freedoms for a young person. And this is how he contrasted the transitory freedom with the basic. Basic means the basic freedom, where you want to live, you can live, where you want to go, you should go, where what you want to read. This is the basic freedom, I think. Okay, next is, and as a as an adult, it should be said that basic freedom is paying respect and honor to the society. That is basic freedom, and the transitory freedom is the decisions he wants to take in his life. That is called the phase of transitory freedoms. Okay, number three, does Nelson Mandela think the oppressor is free? No. He is the slave of prejudice, the slave of, you can say, narrow-mindedness and hatred. Okay, that's all for today. I think you all have understood the chapter very well. Thank you for watching.